Good morning, students. So, in continuation with our chapter cell, and in that cell chapter, we are studying the cell organelles. In last video, we completed the ribosomes and cytoskeleton, and now we will study the cilia and flagella. So, these cilia and flagella, which are present in cell, they are fine hair-like, and movable protoplasmic processes of a cell. And usually these cilia and flagella, they are responsible for producing a current in fluid medium, and this current, it helps in locomotion or movement. So these cilia and flagella, they are fine hair-like structures present in the cell, they are protoplasmic structures present in a cell and responsible for the production of current in the fluid medium that helps in the locomotion or movement. Now, these flagella, they are much longer in size as compared to the cilia. So these flagella, their length is near about 100 to 200 micrometer. As these flagella, they are longer in size, but they are less in number as compared to the cilia. A cell only contains 1 to 4 flagella, that is only 1 to 4 flagella are present per cell, whereas these cilia, they are much smaller in size as compared to the flagella. They are only 5 to 20 micrometer in size, but they are numerous in number. That means they are present in large number. Now, both cilia and flagella, structurally they consist of the similar or identical four components. That is the basal body, the rootlets, the basal plate and the shaft. Now, we will study all these in details. Now come to the parts of these cilia and flagella. The first is basal body. So this basal body, it is also known as kinetosome or basal granules. And these basal body, they are usually found on the outer part of the cytoplasm just below the plasma membrane. Now this basal body, it is similar to microcylinder and they have a structure similar to the centriole with 9 triplet fibers present on periphery without a central fiber, but it contains a hub of proteins in the center. Only the subfiber A is complete with 13 protofilaments in case of cilia or in case of basal body, and the protofilaments B and C, they are incomplete and they share their protofilaments with each other. Now come to the second part of this cilia and flagella, that is rootlets. These rootlets are striated fibrillar outgrowth and they develop from the lower part of the basal body, and usually they are responsible for providing support to the basal body. Now the third part of this cilia and flagella is basal plate, and this basal plate, it is the area which lies below the basal body and they are responsible for providing support to the basal body. Now come to the fourth part of the cilia and flagella, that is shaft. So this shaft are hair-like projecting part of cilium or cilia. In case of cilia, the length of this shaft is near about 5 to 20 micrometer, and in case of flagella, the length of this shaft is 100 to 200 micrometer. Now on outer side, this shaft, it is covered with a proteinaceous sheath which is made up of plasma membrane, or which is the extension of plasma membrane. So on outer side, this shaft is covered with a sheath, and this sheath is the extension of plasma membrane. Now internally, this shaft, it contains a semi-fluid matrix that is known as exonyme. So internally, whatever the matrix present in it, it is known as exonyme, and this exonyme contains 9 peripheral doublet fibrils. So these are B and A, these all are doublet fibrils. These have two fibrils, that is A and B. So it have 9 peripheral doublet fibers and 2 central singlet fibers. So this arrangement, that is 9 peripheral doublet fibers and 2 singlet fibers, it is known as 9 plus 2 arrangement. So this matrix, that is exonemy, it contains 9 peripheral doublet fibers and 2 central cigrillate fibers, and this arrangement is called 9 plus 2 arrangement. Further, the peripheral fibers, they, each peripheral fiber, it contains 2 subunits as B and A. So in each peripheral fiber there are 2 subunits or microtubules which are known as B and A microtubules or subunits. Further, 2 central cigrillate fibers are covered with a proteinaceous sheath and are connected to doublet bridge. So the 2 central cigrillate fibers, they are covered with a proteinaceous sheath and they are connected to the doublet bridge. This is the bridge, that is, this is the bridge through which they are connected. Now peripheral fibers, they are attached through A and B linker. So each peripheral fiber, that is this peripheral fiber, it is attached to this peripheral fiber, and this, it is connected to this peripheral fiber through A and B linker. So this is the outer covering, it is the flagellar sheath, that is the extension of plasma membrane. Then all the matrix that is present inside it, it is known as exonemy. This is A, B and A, this is peripheral doublet fibers, and this structure which connects this internal proteinaceous sheath to this doublet fiber, it is known as spoke. This spoke, it contains its head which is connected to the proteinaceous sheath. The one peripheral fiber, doublet fiber, connected to another peripheral doublet fibril through A and B linker. So this is B, A and B linker. This is the cingulate central sheath, and this is, we have two arms on this A fiber, subfiber, that is outer side arm and inner side arm, and this is the central sheath. So this is the structure of complete shaft, and here we complete the cilia and flagella.